My name is Monique Lawson. I interviewed 72 people, but I could only view the video of 244 people because the others weren't, like, I couldn't say they weren't interested, but they find it too hard to speak about HIV. How did I interview the people? I developed questions about HIV, possible questions. And question one was, how do you feel when people speak about HIV? 24 adults answered saying HIV is not something to speak about easily. And 48 teenagers said they're scared when they hear people speak about HIV. Question two was, what comes to mind when you hear the word HIV? I get scared, I think it's scary, so I don't want to speak about it, I don't want to hear it, although it's normal. Question three was, do you know the difference between HIV and adults of 72? In my street, say she knows what HIV is, but she doesn't know the difference between HIV and AIDS. And she would really like to know the difference. Question four was, how would you react if one of your family members had HIV and 14 teenagers say, I would not welcome it because it's not fair? Question five was, who would you tell if you could be infected with HIV? And teenagers say, one teenager out of the 48 teenagers said, I would tell no one because if they were infected, they wouldn't tell me. Question six was, if you found out that your girlfriend had HIV and planned to sleep with you without telling you she was infected, how would you react? I would kill them on the spot because they're selfish. Question seven was, is there any chance that you would date a positive person? 70 people say no, I would put my life in risk. Question eight is there any chance of you staying in a relationship after finding out that your partner is HIV? 23 people say, life is a blessing, so say people. So why give a blessing up when I'm running to death? Question nine said, why would people not speak about HIV? We human, we feel, and we scared. Question 10 is, have you ever watched sugar? 2 say we have viewed sugar, but not problem. 70 say yes, we would like to view sugar. After viewing sugar, 44 viewers say sugar is something that shows us how life could be if we only could stand together and run a race together. HIV is not dead.
I watched sugar before, and then
there were question asking, and there were some possible things that doesn't happen in reality. So I was trying to debate on the thing that I watched. So I asked questions, and some questions that were asked here during the thing that we were sitting here, there were questions that they asked. So I just put questions together and just asked about HIV, as long as it's about HIV.
This is a school for the arts, but you're a scientist, eh?
It's drama.
You're in drama pop. You're drama pop.
Thinking out of the box.
Ah.
Yes.
I'm thinking auditions. Wait, hold on, MDB. Auditions. Say your name again.
Simone Klaassen.
Okay, what's your phone number?
084-24-50-57.
Excellent. Well done.
These last days, and I showed it to quite a few friends. My one friend's reaction was, my mother never told her about this. She was shocked for the first time. Mother, when she saw this movie, she was quite shocked because her mother never told her about this. And I think the movie is great because it makes people aware of HIV, and this is a reality. It doesn't happen on television. It's a reality, and many people can get infected. And it's not because, mostly people think that if a person's HIV positive, they sleep around and so. But some people actually born with the disease. Mm-hmm. I showed it to another girl also, and she was like, MTV sugar is actually great because, at first I thought it was only in black countries that happened. But I saw many people, and so a person I know is also infected. And I was scared of her because I was like, I can get infected if I was being with her. And then afterwards I realized that I don't have to be afraid or ashamed. She's a close friend of mine and I have to be positive and support her.
Hi everybody, I'm Lavelle Peterson and I just want to say I saw this MTV Sugar movie to my family and most of them were positive about the story and they said they're going to look differently at HIV positive people and treat them differently.
Oh. My name is Lindsay and on primary school I had this friend and a few weeks ago when I saw him I was on my way to ShopRite. And then he actually confessed to me that he has HIV. And then I told him, I couldn't tell him sorry, so I can't tell him how I feel or tell him I know how you feel because I don't know how he feels like. And I wouldn't know because I wasn't in that position or not in that position that he is in. And it's difficult to see how people can break down and keep things to themselves where they can speak about it and feel much better. If they speak about these things and see that there is really people that cares and it will always support them through things like that.
So, but you watched Sugar Season 4, correct? Did that in any way help you understand how it is to be HIV positive?
Yes, much better.
In what way? I mean,
in the way that there's people that do keep it to themselves and don't know how to talk to others about it, and then there's people that don't care, that feels free to talk to others about it and say it even on television, do they feel there's no shame to HIV. That's why I feel there's two sides to HIV.
So, what character moved you in Sugar?
The couple that actually felt more comfortable talking to others about it, and she always supporting him through whatever, and even through her family who said, oh no, I don't want him in my house. But she kept him and showed him that no matter what, she will always love him. And even though he has HIV.
Would you like to be like that? That kind of person?
What would it take for you, or from you, to accept somebody in a romantic relationship who is HIV positive? What must happen? What would make you do that? Look at the camera when you answer, don't look at me. I'm the bad person here. The camera is good.
What would it take? It would take a lot of courage to be in a relationship with someone who has HIV because why? You're not only, you actually like, you, anything could happen. You could also be infected, so it's a difficult decision to make to be with someone who has HIV.
So is it fear?
No, it's not fear.
So you say because your first response would be, but I can get infected. I can get infected. That's fear.
It's your choice that you make. The choice you make determines on your future. So if you, with someone who have AIDS, then you should know that what you putting yourself to, that you know you could be infected. But if you love that person, then there's no such thing that's stronger than love.
Yeah.